Hello everyone, this is Mike from Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Welcome back to Liquid Audio, cherishing classic audio. And today we're cherishing this TEAC P-30 CD drive. Now this is an absolute pearler, and this is one of those stories where you're going to have to forgive me because unfortunately I did not video the process. And look, the reason is simple. I didn't video it because these videos that I've been making, I just haven't got time to edit them, put them together and put them onto YouTube. So it's been shooting footage and it just sort of slows me down. This came to me dead. It did not work. The tray wouldn't come out. It wouldn't read discs. It was knackered. Okay, so what we did was replaced two belts, of course, the standard thing. I'm going to put some photos in here to show you what I've done. I've had this whole thing apart. This whole mech has been out. We had the little, I'll put photos in and you'll see, but the little, so there's a belt here, underneath here, around about here, that is the tray loader belt. And there is another belt down and around here, which you'll see in the photo, that is the belt for driving the CD platter and pushing the CD up onto the clamp, and which is the direct drive motor which spins the disc. That was great, got all that working, pulled it all apart, replaced the belts, lubricated everything, got it working. Very, very good. But the next thing, of course, was that after that, the player wouldn't read discs properly. It still wouldn't play properly. Well, now let's have a look. Let's just see what happens here. I've come back to it after a little break here. Here we have my Queen CD. This is the one that's very scratched. This one basically is a test disc for me because of how badly brutalized it is. And I find there's a couple of tracks on here that are really hard to read. And if a player will read them, I know that it is running well. So you saw how well that tray came out. Let's load again. Let's hit play actually, and let's just see what happens. And I'm not gonna play the audio here because I don't wanna do that. Don't wanna play the audio. I just wanna show you the player itself working. And you can see, look at that. Track one, playing beautifully. Now I know you're thinking, well, Mike, is it really playing? Look, it is really playing because you can see here, you can read the digits for yourself. It is really playing. It's actually playing the track perfectly. You can come up here and you can see it for yourself if you don't believe me. You can see the disc spinning here in the mech. It is spinning perfectly. Now, to get this happening, to get this part happening, reading the disc, playing the disc well, I had to do all of what I've talked about before. I've had many people ask me about this. Mike, can you show yourself doing it? Can you explain how it's done? All of these adjustments have to be done. There's focus, gain, and balance. And there's tracking, gain, and balance. And there's usually, but not always, there's usually a VCO adjustment. And there is here. And you know, there's a bunch of stuff really that has to be tweaked, if you like, whilst you're using the player, listening to the disc, listening to the sound that the player makes, because by listening to the sound it makes, that tells us a lot about how it's running. And the fact now, I don't know if you can hear that, but it is almost, you can just hear it, but it's almost silent, and that's a very good sign. It means the servos aren't working too hard. Now, what else did I have to do? Well, I had to clean the laser optics, of course. As I mentioned, I had to service the mech and replace those belts. I had to clean the inside of the player. I had to clean the linear mech and make sure that everything there was smooth. In fact, the The laser didn't move very smoothly on the sled, and that was part of the issue. So I had to lubricate the bearing rail, which I was trying to see if I could show you in here. I can't. So this is a very bad video. I do apologize, guys. And as I said, this will be, I'll be interspersing this with photos so that you can kind of see what I'm talking about. But the main thing I wanted to do is just sort of crow about just how happy I was. That's why I'm drinking a beer here. To crow about just how happy I was to fix this P30, because the owner loves it. And why wouldn't you? I mean, just look at this thing. This is like, you know, 15 kilos of just beautiful CD transport. What's not to love about this? Despite all of Clifford D'Souza's bodgery in here, this is a guy in Perth who, for many years, just tweaked, I use the word very, very loosely, tweaked equipment and just kind of mucked around with stuff and, you know, damaged things and, you know, built kit amps and sold them. And unfortunately, many people fell for this, and many people were sucked in by this kind of modification madness, I'm going to call it, because there are lots of sensible mods that you can do that really improve things. And there are mods like this that, if they're done well, are worth getting done. But there are others that just aren't worth doing. And I don't know, when I look at all of this and I look at kind of how it's all hokily attached in here, stuff is free to sort of flap around. There's various tacked in caps that just haven't been well implemented or installed. And, you know, there's a bunch of stuff here that I would have done very differently and very much more neatly. That being said, I don't mind if it's not falling out, and most of this isn't. This thing, I think, impacts the roof. Whatever this is, power supply of some sort, impacts the roof. The lid of the player, that's a problem. But anyhow, oh, and of course there's some stripped screws and things like that, which is normal when this guy's worked on things. But look, other than that, I have to say, thank goodness this player is still working, and you can see we're still playing track one. What a wonderful result this is. Sorry for one of my worst videos of all time in terms of just the handheld nature of it, the shakiness, and the lack of footage of me doing anything. I do apologize, but I wanted to say that this was not working. It now works perfectly. It's resurrected. It's good. We fix CD players here. We're not really known for that particularly, but we fix a lot of CD players. People have commented, do you really fix CD players? Well, you can see for yourself that, yeah, we fix some of the trickiest ones and get them working when almost no one else can. Now, mostly I work on amplifiers, tuners, preamps, but really I'm known for amps. And the main thing I work on alongside amps is turntables. So turntables are a big, big part of what we do. You'll see turntables everywhere here. And obviously that is a huge, huge element of what we do. Sorry for the dust on these people's turntables. I promise it will be removed. Sonabs, Pioneers, Denons, Technics, all sorts of things here. And yeah, turntables are a big, big part of what we do. But having said that, you know, obviously there are many, many other things that we work on. Cassette decks, tuners, all sorts of kooky amps, and yeah, just so happens that CD players are something I've always worked on since I started doing this more than 10 years ago, 15, 20 years ago. CD players have been an absolute love and passion of mine. Now, I don't make it a focus these days, but when I get a nice player like this that comes in and when I'm able to get it working, it makes me really, really happy. So this is a good example of that. Anyway, enough of my rant. Is it still playing? Yes, it is still playing. Sorry, I don't know what's going on with the focus here on my new phone, but there we go. So thanks a lot for watching, everyone. Please like, subscribe, comment if it's positive. And yeah, if we can work on your CD player and get it up and running, I'd be very happy to do that. Thanks a lot for watching, everyone. See ya.